you know, law can unquestionably play an important role in environmental activism. I'd like to get your opinion on what in your view the role of environmental NGOs is today.
But the role of environmental NGOs is very important for a number of reasons. I mean, they are really meant to speed up society's understanding of these problems, and then speed up the action of politicians, corporations, in dealing with these problems. Because even though now people are pretty well on track to understand that there are problems, the movement that we're making towards solving them is just too slow. Some will take action in the form of demonstrations. Some, like me, will take action in the form of bringing lawsuits.
There's such a pragmatism to the approach with ClientEarth, like constantly trying to work out what way you can get to this ideal end point. But, you know, it seems that you have to keep the horizons so broad, you know, because your one channel approach isn't going to necessarily get you there.
So about 5 years ago, we said, if you're going to save the environment, you have to move the money in the right direction. You know, so you have to move trillions of dollars away from investment in fossil fuels, you know, coal, oil, gas, all of that. You have to move all that money to renewable energy, for example. That's a really good example. So, well, how do you do that? When we said environmental law on its own isn't enough, you know, because it regulates bad behavior, but it doesn't go to the heart of the money and the decisions about where money go and the responsibilities of how to spend money in the right way. How do you look at securities law as if it were environmental law? How do you look at banking law as if it were environmental law? And we've been doing very cool things. So we just wrote a letter to 17 of the world's biggest banks because they want to finance, they want to give a lot of money to Shell to develop a new oil and gas field. We wrote to the banks saying, look, you are going to be encouraging the development of the oil and gas field in such a way that it will make it harder to meet the Paris Agreement. You will, we think, be violating your fiduciary duty to your shareholders. You may be liable to lawsuits from your shareholders for this behavior. So withdraw from this deal now. Now, that was very public, and I made it very simple, but it's a very long legal letter. And we'll see what they do. If they're smart, they'll decide, well, we're not going to fund this.
Yeah.
If they don't, there is the potential then for litigation against them to stop the funding. Now, 6 years ago, I wouldn't have thought, you know, that we could do that. But but now, after looking at all of these other specialties as areas of law that are can be used just as much for the environment as environmental law itself, I love the synergies that you get.
Yeah,
you bring all these areas of law. It's very dynamic.
That type of that, you know, process of writing a letter to send to the banks, that sounds just like quite fun to me. Yeah, so like
well, it is, you know. And you know, you're right, law can seem very dry, and it on its own it is very dry. What I can do with it is very exciting.
Yeah,
just so powerful. And I mean, I'll give you another example since we're talking about banks. So you know, we were saying how do you move the money in the right direction? Well, so Europe, so the EU has something it calls the Green Deal. Everything we do as the EU must look at the environment and give an environmental benefit. I mean, it's a beautiful concept. Then the question, as always, is what does it mean in the real world? So nice idea. Does it actually mean anything? So then the EU decided it was going to do what's called quantitative easing. They were going to put a lot of money into the economy to help the economy post-COVID, and a lot of money, 750 billion euros. So good idea from an economist's point of view, help the economy after COVID. We said, is it actually going to meet the terms of the Green Deal? Will it, all that money, will it help Europe move towards being greener? So we looked at an analysis from the London School of Economics. And the European Central Bank was simply going to buy bonds, which is how you do this, according to a standard formula. And the London School of Economics Grantham Institute looked at that and said, well, actually that standard formula would mean that over 60% of this money went to fossil fuel in one way or another, to oil companies or to other fossil fuel related entities. So it's not green at all. And so $750 billion, you put it towards green economy. Wow, $750 billion, you put more than 60% towards fossil fuel economy, and you're moving backwards. So we said, what can we do about that? So we said, well, you know, we think this is illegal under the Green Deal and under the Treaty of Europe. So we looked at how the bonds are actually bought, and then the bonds would be bought by six central banks. So so we went to, we have an office in Belgium, so we sued the Central Bank of Belgium and said, this bond purchase that you're about to do, you know, violates the Green Deal and violates the Treaty of Europe. You're an entity of the government, and you're required to look at the environmental impacts of this. You just can't do this. And, you know, it also kind of met a lifetime goal of mine of suing a central bank.
That is a dream come true, isn't it?
But we'll see where we go. But if we go up to the European Court and win, then what will happen is cool. And so one of the interesting things about using law in the way we do is it's like playing 60 chess games, you know, you're looking ahead, playing this very good game. Because what we were trying to do is, how do you influence that quantitative easing decision? Well, the woman who runs the European Central Bank, Christine Lagarde, wants to do the right thing. She actually wanted that bond purchase to foster the Green Deal. But the bank governors said, no, we have a very narrow mandate, was the term. We can't look at the real world impacts of our decision, only the fiscal impacts, the financial impacts. So, which is just madness, you know. We said, no, took them to court. And if we win, then in the European Court, then Christine Lagarde will get the space to do what she wanted to do, but didn't have the power to do. If you go into the system and look at it holistically, how can you move that money towards a good green result? Well, you put all of these pieces together and then find a lever, which happened to be banking. And we'll see if we win. But win or lose, it's a very good shot